As promised in the last video, if you want your son to have a large penis, what food must your pregnant partner eat so she doesn't get in the way of great things happening? We are talking about hacking biology here, and it's possible, but you can't beat genetics. Sorry. You'll learn about that as we go. And here's another pro tip I'll be giving you: how to have powerful impact of penile growth phase 2. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, one of the most copied urologists on YouTube. I am sure this video is gonna be a viral hit. So just for you to remember, it's uploaded October 22nd, 2025. You'll see copycats jumping onto this topic pretty soon. Let's talk about the very foundation of penis size. You're gonna love it. The foundation of penis growth isn't a supplement or a superfood. It's testosterone. It hits the unborn baby as early as between weeks 10 to 15 during pregnancy. Hard to believe, isn't it? But this phase is crucial. It's defining for your adult life. You can actually test how much testosterone you got at that age. Just look at the ratio of your index and ring fingers. If you haven't watched my video about it, maybe you should. Intrauterine testosterone is the first boost to penis growth, but only within genetic limitations. The genes for penis size are a contribution from the mother. So if you want to know her genetic potential, just look at her family. Then you know the blueprint. Testosterone is powerful, but let it work its magic. Diet has a big impact. What the mother eats and what she's exposed to can make a difference. Let's start with the obvious enemies. First, industrial junk. Ready meals, ultra-processed foods, they are loaded with plasticizers and softeners like phthalates. These aren't harmless. They're endocrine disruptors. They interfere with the signal testosterone is trying to send. Second, refined sugar bombs. A diet that keeps maternal insulin chronically high shifts the intrauterine environment toward inflammation and altered placental signaling. Testosterone doesn't like that. Third, alcohol and nicotine. Even small amounts reduce placental oxygenation, but more importantly, they induce oxidative stress. And oxidative stress blocks hormonal cascades like a dam blocking a river. Fourth, microplastics and softeners. They're not just in food wrappers, they are in the water, they're in cosmetics, they're in your daily life. You can't eliminate them completely, but you can minimize exposure. And in that window, every bit matters. Now, let's flip the script. What actually helps testosterone unfold its full power? Protein and micronutrient sufficiency. Not steak overload, not protein shakes, but enough building blocks for the placenta to work efficiently. Healthy fats, especially omega-3s. They support fetal Leydig cell function, the cells that produce testosterone. Antioxidants from vegetables, herbs, spices. They're not woo-woo. They neutralize free radicals, keeping that hormonal cascade clean and sharp. Stable glucose metabolism, which means fewer spikes, more balance. Think Mediterranean pattern, not fast food highway. Low exposure to endocrine disruptors, glass over plastic, fresh over packaged. It's not about magic foods. It's about creating an environment where the fetal testis can do what it's supposed to do, without noise. Do you want to know a life hack? Ever struggled with toddlers not willing to eat their spinach? Here's the trick. Research has shown that our taste buds develop under the influence of what our mothers ate when they were pregnant with us. In other words, if you want your son to love Brussels sprouts, your partner should eat those during pregnancy. And that's exactly why this series exists, to give you biological hacks that actually work. So if you don't want to miss the next one, hit subscribe and ring the bell now, because what comes next might be even more important. The food industry will try everything to make your son fat. And that's a fact. There are food deserts in the US. Not a single Brussels sprout in sight for hundreds of kilometers. What I just told you is the best insurance against that. No sugar and unhealthy fats during pregnancy. I know it's hard work, but it'll pay off. because obese boys are at risk for small penises in adult life. This is what my next video will be about. So if you don't want to miss out on that information, just subscribe and activate the bell. If we just leave penis size for a second. Guys, don't make your partner unhappy by obsessing over penis size. As I said, genetics has a word in this too. Being pregnant is not a walk in the park. Lots of hormones involved. It's a vulnerable time. So please support your partner. However, eating healthy is never wrong. Maybe you remember that old saying that once pregnant, you should eat for two? That's outdated. By keeping a healthy diet during pregnancy and not gaining excessive weight, it will also be easier after pregnancy. So talk to each other. You might want to get nutritional advice from a local dietitian. I'm sure they'll be happy to help. So why is penile size always inherited from the mother's side? It has to do with the sex chromosomes. While you wait for my video on obese boys and small penises, check out this video while you wait. And subscribe so you won't miss the next one. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.